is remdesivir being projected as a miracle drug?
Don't give status of miracle drug to the remdesivir. It's not elixir.
And why is there so much of hue and cry over this drug?
So if we don't control now these things, then there will be disaster in next 3 to 4 weeks.
Dr. Sandeep Gore, Director Emergency Medicine in Fortis Hospital in Mumbai, is joining us. Thank you, Dr. Sandeep Gore, for joining me. Dr. Sandeep Gore is leading a team of emergency doctors in pandemic-struck Mumbai. And ever since the start of the pandemic, he has been treating over 3 dozen COVID patients on a daily basis. Dr. Sandeep, everyone today in the country is speaking about remdesivir, the antiviral drug, which is more or less being projected as a wonder drug. When it comes to treating COVID patients, I want to know how effective is remdesivir really? Because I want to talk to you about the drug itself. For instance, the World Health Organization had conducted a solidarity trial of 4 antiviral drugs, remdesivir, hydroxychloroquine, lopinavir, and interferon. This study was conducted in 405 hospitals in 30 countries. 11,000 adults underwent randomization, amongst which, when it comes to remdesivir alone, 2,750 COVID patients were given remdesivir. Now, the solidarity trial's interim results found a very important thing, which says that remdesivir had little or no effect on overall mortality, initiation of ventilation, and duration of hospital stay in hospitalized patients with COVID-19. If that is the case, if remdesivir doesn't have any effect on COVID patients, why is remdesivir being projected as a miracle drug?
Yeah, the first thing I would like to reiterate that there is a myth that this remdesivir is a life-saving drug or public taking it as elixir for life. It's absolutely wrong thing. As you told, the biggest study on remdesivir happened and which is conducted by World Health Organization. That clearly says that this injection remdesivir will not reduce the stay of the patient in the hospital. Neither it prevents patient going on a ventilator, nor it reduces the mortality. So it's a clear cut drug that it has a very little effect on patient outcome. And this is not my opinion. Nowadays, we practice the evidence-based medicine. So with the solidarity trial, which is funded by World Health Organization, it clearly says, and with that reference, I am talking in very responsibility that remdesivir has a little role in COVID management. So through the probe, I would like to appeal to the people that don't give status of miracle drug to the remdesivir. It's not elixir.
Are we actually talking only about the World Health Organization's study? Because even the World Health Organization's chief scientist, Dr. Soumya Swaminathan, she has been speaking about the findings from 5 clinical trials internationally. And all the 5 trials, she says, shows that remdesivir did not reduce the need for mechanical ventilation among those suffering from COVID, and it didn't help curtail mortality. Then my question to you is, doctor, then why is there so much of hue and cry over this drug?
Yeah, I think March 2020, the similar hype was there about hydroxychloroquine. Such a media hype was there that hydroxychloroquine will prevent the COVID infection, or it may helpful in treatment of the COVID. But over the time, it turned as a myth. I think media has to be very much responsible thing. They should come with evidence-based knowledge, and the evidence-based knowledge says that the remdesivir has very little role in management of COVID patient, and we have to spread this. And if we spread this and if we go and tell people this evidence-based information, I think it will reduces the panickiness in the entire country. It will also reduces the so-called black marketing happen over the drug and holding of this drug.
Yeah. So if you have been treating scores of COVID patients every day. If remdesivir is not really helping COVID patients in a big way or in a small way, what then is actually working on COVID patients? So from your experience, please tell me what really works on COVID patients.
So far with the literature as well as of my experience of my colleagues, only two life-saving things are there in COVID management. One is oxygen and second is steroids. So oxygen, whenever there is a drop of oxygen, the person requires oxygen and ventilatory support. Okay, that can be high flow nasal cannula, that can be non-invasive ventilation, or sometimes patient has to be put on a ventilator, or simply some patient do well with 2 to 4 liters of oxygen. And if that period of 12 to 14 days over, they will get recovered. So oxygen has a major role in patient's survival benefit. And same, timely administration of the steroid. After 8 to 9 days, when the cytokine activity occurs, at that time, if we give steroid at a proper time, that will prevent the death. So there are only two things which can save the patient from COVID deaths or COVID mortality, or only two things are life-saving in COVID management. One is oxygen, and second is timely utilization of steroid. I am using the word timely because if we take the steroids in earlier stage, that can be that can harm patient. It's like a double-edged sword. So it has to be given under the medical supervision and very meticulously.
Yeah. So also, if you look at what has been happening in the country in the last couple of days, for instance, in Gujarat, you know, a top executive of a Daman-based pharmaceutical company and his aide, they were arrested for allegedly black marketing remdesivir drug. In Bangalore also, recently we saw the news of 3 persons being arrested for illegal stocking and black marketing of remdesivir injections. And not just this, across the country, many are indulging in hoarding and black marketing of the drug. So I just want to know if there is no evidence from international trials that remdesivir in fact helps COVID-19 patients, then why is it being made out like a wonder drug? Why is a false narrative being created around the drug? What are your thoughts on it? Who is doing it and for whose benefit?
You can't say means the false narrative, rather than I can say it's a look like sometimes the media hype. I can say if you look at the new channel in last some 4 or 5 days, you can see it has been portrayed that people are dying due to lack of injection of remdesivir, and that's actually not right thing. Like, remdesivir has very little role to do with mortality. So if we responsibility spread the right things for the people, I think we can elevate the panic which is generated all over the country due to this scarcity of remdesivir. It will go, and once people know what is right and what are the facts about remdesivir, I think automatically the hoarding and black marketing and all these practices will stop. Because Prima, we are practicing a modern medicine, and modern medicine practices on evidence, and evidence says, the most recent evidence that I'm talking about this particular Solidarity trial, it says that remdesivir has no role or very little role in COVID management. And that, as a responsible journalist, you as a responsible medical professional, me, we have to go and tell these people that this is a fact, and you should not get panicky, because there are only two things which saves lives. One is oxygen and supportive ventilation, and timely utilization of steroid. And both of things, I think, adequately we have in our country now.
The center on April 11th banned the export of remdesivir, and many state governments have directed hospitals to administer the drug to only those suffering from a severe case of COVID-19 infection. But is this the most effective treatment for COVID-19? If it isn't, and it shouldn't be, because none of the top rated scientists or trials have validated this as the best choice for treatment, then when governments here I'm saying both state government and as well as the central government, when they make it out as the most sought after drug, does it not really show a lack of medical knowledge or understanding of the science behind COVID treatment from the part of the establishment, both at the center and the state level?
No, I can't say that, because in Maharashtra state, there is a COVID task force. And I read the Maharashtra state COVID task force chief, Dr. Shashank, has clearly made statement that COVID has very little role in, remdesivir has very little role in COVID management. knowledge they have, but the way the knowledge has to be percolated at grassroots level, that is not happening. I think everyone has the knowledge, everyone knows about the solidarity trial in medical fraternity also, but public don't know, is not aware about these things. And through the media, if we could put forth these facts in front of common public, I think it will be of immensely helpful.
Yeah. Now, there have been shortage of oxygen cylinders. There are no beds left in many hospitals, no ventilators. We don't want to even discuss the lack of space to bury the dead. But the fact is, the patients who are living with COVID and who are suffering are in dire need of help. And that is the situation right now. As an emergency doctor who is actually treating COVID patients every day and who is leading a team of doctors on the ground level, what do you think, instead of focusing on remdesivir, what according to you should be the focus of the government at this point?
The focus of the government should be, means I recommend that first thing, that this is the most period of the crucial period of the pandemic. These next 2 to 3 weeks are the most crucial phase, and it depends how we handle these things. So I think that there is a need of complete lockdown, means this disease is spreading very fast. And right now, more than 95% of our medical infrastructure is getting filled with this COVID management. And suppose this number becomes double, then it's very difficult to manage the entire show. Because we see these patients are directly coming from home with severe hypoxia, some 50% of oxygen saturation, and young people also. So if we don't control now these things, then there will be disaster in next 3 to 4 weeks. So my thing is that I think lockdown, which is partial lockdown, is going on in Maharashtra and I think Delhi. I think complete lockdown will be definitely helpful in these things, because life prevails over everything. Second thing is that people should behave responsibly. They should wear the mask. They should avoid the gathering at the religious event or political event, or maybe marriages. They should absolutely avoid these things, right? And they should behave responsibly. Their own life is their responsibility. The family member's life is also their responsibility. So if everyone recognizes their responsibility and behave in responsible manner, I think we can control this spread. Moreover, now, just while discussing with you, I heard that this government of India made the vaccination available up to age of 18 years. If we do the 24/7 vaccination continuously with strict lockdown, I think collectively it will generate some herd immunity and it will prevent the further spread.
Yeah. So our country's production of remdesivir has gone up from 2.8 million to 4.1 million vials per month during the last week. And many companies producing remdesivir in India have slashed prices of the drug. Now, why is all this happening? And how is this really helping the present situation? Isn't this a classic case of misplaced priorities?
Yeah, I think public awareness is very much important in these things. Because now also you see 85% of COVID patients will get cured on its own. If you don't do anything, they will get cured. So only some 15 to 10% people who requires medical care. For your information, I can say that this NHS, National Health Trust, they have removed injection remdesivir from their treatment management. And NHS is considered as one of the best healthcare system in that world. So we have to believe, these are the facts. I think we have to go and talk to the public this fact and evidence-based information.
Yeah, you spoke about NHS. Even the World Health Organization also, they had issued a conditional recommendation against the use of remdesivir in hospitalized patients. Regardless of disease severity, they say that there is no evidence that proves that remdesivir improves survival and other outcomes in COVID patients. When such is the case, what is the best course of treatment currently available for a COVID patient? What works and what doesn't work? And if you can also talk about how different is this second wave of COVID from the initial wave that we saw last year? And what is the difference, because various mutations and variants of the virus is doing the round right now. Medically, when you are seeing a patient right now, how different is that patient compared to a patient who would have come to you last year?
Okay, It is a comprehensive question, so I will answer in comprehensive manner. The first thing is that this wave is a bigger wave, and due to the mutant testing, this is spreading very fast. And in last year, we have seen that only one member of family getting infected and other are remaining safe. Now, this time, entire family is getting affected due to this. So this virus is quite contagious. And what we should do in these things? I think there is lots of burden on the labs also. It takes some 2 to 3 days to report a COVID test. I think one thing I would like to point out, and one thing I would like to emphasize here, that if anybody getting fever, or every fever should be considered as due to COVID unless proven otherwise. So if any person gets a fever, he should immediately isolate himself. He should wear the mask, he should make the test. And until he get the test report, he should remain quarantined. Now what is happening? People are giving the test, and till they get the report, they are mixing in the entire population and they are spreading to the other members, community members or their family members or their neighbors. So one should keep in this mind, every fever is COVID unless proven otherwise. If fever is there, till reports come, the person should isolate himself from the other members. Second thing is that not every patient requires admission. So home-based care for the COVID, I think that we should encourage, because if we try to admit all the patient of COVID, that is impossible. So we should encourage the home-based care of the care, and those patients who's having use of pulse oximeter at home or thermometer at home, those people who are oxygenation level less than 94%, I think these people we should keep for the admission and inpatient purposes. And if we do this in a rational manner, I think we can utilize our limited resources following the principle of maximum good for the maximum people.
Yeah. Also, before you leave, doctor, as we always say, prevention is better than cure. So with new variants and mutations of the virus doing the round, what new precautions should we take to keep ourselves and our near and dear ones safe from the virus?
The precautions are the same, because precautions are the same. The one thing is that avoid unnecessary outing. If only essential thing, one should go out. If somebody is going out, they should wear the mask. If possible, they should use the triple ply mask, that surgical mask. If not, they can use this cloth mask also. But no one should go out of home without mask, and they should maintain the distancing from the other people, some 6 feet distance and all these things. And if everyone wears the mask and maintains the approximate distance, that will prevent the spread. Moreover, vaccination is going on, so we should encourage the vaccination, which the people who are suitable, the age group people, or now I can say this from 1st of May, vaccination will be for people whose age is more than 18 years. I think they should go and take this vaccination. I think vaccination is an effective way to reduce the severity of the disease as well as stop the spreading of the disease. And adequate routine things means when one go out, he should and come into the home, he should take a bath, change the clothes, and if they get any symptoms, immediately he should isolate himself from the family and he should do the test. And he should remain isolated until the result comes. I think these basic precautions, if we follow, that we are bombarding on public since last 1 year. Our telephone ring also same, that if they follow the same thing, I think they can protect themselves from this double mutant strain also.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Sandeep Gore, for talking to the probe.
Thank you.